Having an assignment to write a research paper may be in the same category as a dentist telling you that you need a root canal. Neither will be painless, but each can be made less painful when having a positive attitude and knowing what to expect. The analogy that writing a research paper is like a marathon rather than like a sprint race is frequently used. It's time-consuming, it doesn't always go smoothly, and can even be painful at times. But understanding and applying what needs to be done before, during and after will help you run that research writing race. This course will help you understand the writing decisions that will need to be made, and to anticipate potential barriers, so you can take steps to either avoid, if possible, the problem areas, or at least to minimize them. The writing process is emphasized in every writing course. As with any process, enough time needs to be allowed for each step or stage. The lessons in this course will help you realize the importance of managing your time throughout the entire process. Also, all three of the pre-writing methods are discussed and illustrated. And then you'll learn how that pre-writing stage will help you prepare a structured outline. We'll look at how you can select a research-worthy topic, and how to turn that idea into a strong thesis statement, and then how to select research to support that thesis. How much, how to find it, what sources are credible, and how to document those sources. And finally, the course will emphasize the importance of the revision process. So, let's begin on the research paper journey. Why is publishing important? If you're a graduate student, you may ask yourself to do or not to do a PhD. What will happen if I follow that track? You have just begun your PhD and wondering how to present your research right. In which genre should you publish? For starters, you should know that one of the main tasks of the researcher is to spread their work and present it to peers. We need to understand academia and how publishing is a very critical component for a researcher to advance the scientific knowledge. Publication is a form of expression and communication. By putting your ideas together in a resourceful way and publishing it, it allows you to share your results. If scientists kept their results in the lab, there will be no real-world progress. Publication can also help you feel stronger about your work by getting important criticism back from reviewers who are experts in your field. It also enables you to get familiar with other academics working on your topic. Furthermore, if you are thinking about continuing your academic life, publishing is extremely important. You will be evaluated in terms of number of publication and in which kinds of journals you publish. It contributes to determining salaries, academic position, contracts, and grants application. The good things about research is that there is no one standard way. This means there are many ways to share your work and to get published depending on your domain. The main difference between research papers and other forms of publishing is that research papers are often strengthened by facts and statistics. There are different types of scholarly literature, some of which require original research, also regarded as primary literature, and some that are based on other published work or known as secondary literature. It is important to have a clear idea about the different types of articles that you can publish in journals. This will help you understand the ways in which you can disseminate your work and identify what kind of article would be suitable for your study. The types of publications are different in different fields. For instance, a clinical trial is possible only in the field of medicine, while an empirical study is more common in the field of social sciences. It is important to remember that not all journals publish every kind of article. Therefore, most journal publishers provide prospective authors with accurate and specific guidelines for the different articles they publish. Specifications about the types of articles published can be found under the Guidelines to Authors section on a journal's website. If you have a target journal in mind, you should check whether it publishes the kind of manuscript you are planning to write. Some of the possible types of scientific publications are: original research, review article, clinical case study, clinical trial, perspective, opinion, and commentary, and book review. Original articles. Original articles are papers that detailed studies reporting original research and are classified as primary literature. They include hypothesis, background study, methods, results, interpretation of findings, and a discussion of possible implications. These normally require a significant investment of time to collect the primary data and interpret it conclusively. Review article. Review articles provide a critical and constructive analysis of existing published literature in a field, through summary, analysis, and comparison, often identifying specific gaps or problems and providing recommendations for future research. These are considered as secondary literature since they generally do not present new data from the author's experimental work. Review articles can be of three types: literature reviews, systematic reviews, and meta-analyses. Review articles can be of varying lengths depending upon the journal and subject area. Clinical case study. Clinical case studies present the details of real patient cases from medical or clinical practice. The cases presented are usually those that contribute significantly to the existing knowledge on the field. The study is expected to discuss the signs, symptoms, diagnosis, and treatment of a disease. Clinical case studies require a lot of practical experience and may not be a suitable publication format for early career researchers. Clinical trial. Clinical trials describe the methodology, implementation, and results of controlled studies, usually undertaken with large patient groups. Clinical trials often require practical work experience, as well as high standards of ethics and reliability. Perspective, opinion, and commentary. Perspective pieces are scholarly reviews of fundamental concepts or prevalent ideas in a field. These are usually essays that present a personal point of view critiquing widespread notions pertaining to a field. A perspective piece can be a review of a single concept or a few related concepts. These are considered as secondary literature. Opinion articles present the author's viewpoint on the interpretation, analysis, or methods used in a particular study. It allows the author to comment on the strength and weakness of a theory or hypothesis. Opinion articles are usually based on constructive criticism and should be backed by evidence. Such articles promote discussion on current issues concerning science. Commentaries are short articles that draw attention to or present a criticism of a previously published article, book, or report, explaining why it interested them and how it might be illuminating for readers. Finally, book review. Book reviews are published in most academic journals. The aim of a book review is to provide insight and opinion on recently published scholarly books. Book reviews are a good publication option for early career researchers as it allows the researcher to stay abreast of new literature in the field, while at the same time adding to his publication list. Which is easier to publish? An original research article or a review article? A review article is generally more difficult to publish for the simple reason that it is more difficult to write a good quality review than a good quality original research paper. A good review is not just a summary of the existing literature, it has to be really critical and should provide a direction or perspective for future research. This perspective often develops with maturity and long-standing experience of working in the field. In fact, some of the best reviews come from well-respected experts in the field. However, it also depends on the kind of review article you are planning to write. For a narrative review or a literature review, expertise and experience is more important. If you are planning to write a systematic review, you need not be an expert in the field. If you have a good question, and if the review is properly performed, your article will be of good quality. But then again, a systematic review takes a lot of time. If you are thinking in terms of easy publication, I would say an original research article will be a better choice than a review article. However, remember that what matters the most is the quality of your research and how well you have presented it in your manuscript.